In this example, I'm going to solve the quadratic equation 2x squared minus 6x minus 3 equals 0 using the technique completing the square. To do this technique, we want to manipulate the equation so that the left-hand side here is a perfect square. Then we can use the square root property to solve. Unfortunately, what we have here is not a perfect square, so we need to play around with it a bit. First thing I want to do, basically get rid of this 2 in front. That leading coefficient is going to mess everything up. I want it to be a 1, not a 2. In order to do that, I'm going to take both sides of this equation and divide it by 2 so that the 2's cancel out. I'm allowed to do this because it is an equation, and an equation lets me divide by pretty much anything I want, so I can divide both sides by 2. To simplify this, instead of looking at the whole thing over 2, I'm going to break it down term by term and realize that this is 2x squared over 2 minus 6x over 2 minus 3 over 2. And that will be equal to, 0 over 2 is very conveniently still 0. Now I can simplify each one of these terms. The fractions will all cancel out, except for the last one. Notice here, my 2's will simplify, they will divide out, and I am left with just x squared, which is what I wanted in order to complete the square. That's why we divided both sides by 2. Next up, 6x divided by 2 will simplify to 3x. Now the constant term. 3 over 2, since 3 is odd, this is not going to divide evenly. So we have to leave it as is, and instead of writing it as a decimal or a mixed number, it's actually a lot simpler to leave it 3 over 2. So I'm going to leave it just like that, and now have this equal to 0. This is the quadratic we want to use when we start completing the square. Let me move this up so I get a little bit more room here. In completing the square, we're going to want this left-hand side, as I said, to be a perfect square. Right now, it isn't. In order to get it that way, what we want to do is change this constant term to be something else. In order to change it, the easiest thing to do is to move what's here to the other side by adding 3 over 2 to both sides, and then just putting in a new number that actually does work for us. So here you'll notice my 3 over 2's cancel out, and I get x squared minus 3x is equal to 3 over 2. I left a gap here because this is where we're going to fill in a constant term we want. To do that, we first have to figure out what it is and then add it to both sides. So to find out what it is, we follow these same steps every time with every quadratic. You're going to go ahead and take this middle coefficient here, negative 3, and divide it by 2, giving us negative 3 over 2. This is not the number that we're going to add to both sides, but it is very important, which is why I wrote it in red, so that we can keep track of it. So though we're not adding it, we do want to remember it for a step in just a few seconds. To find out what we do add to both sides, what I want to do is take this and square it. So negative 3 over 2 squared. Squaring fractions, they're very simple. It just means square the top, square the bottom, and we're going to end up with here 9 over 4. So that becomes what I add to both sides. I want that constant term here, plus 9 over 4, and since I'm not allowed to just put it in, I have to add it to both sides in order to get it where I want it. So here, because of what we did, we know this side, this left-hand side of the equation, will factor to be a perfect square. The first part, always x. Again, that's why we got rid of that leading coefficient, so that this would be the case. The second term in this binomial, in this factor, is going to be the constant that we had right here when we divided by 2. So that's going to give me x minus 3 over 2. That whole amount squared. And again, that's true every single time you complete the square. It's why this number here is so important, because it is exactly what you end up putting in the factored form. This is going to equal Well, now we got to add these two fractions right here. And there are fractions in this problem, but the fractions work out pretty nicely for us, so there's not that much that we need to do. In order to add these two numbers together, we're going to need to have a common denominator. For us, 4 is going to work for both. So I'm going to take this first one and multiply it top and bottom by 2. Okay. That should give me a new fraction, 6 over 4, which is equivalent to the 3 over 2, plus 9 over 4. Since they have a common denominator, I'm good to go ahead and add. Again, since I'm running low on room, let me move this up so we can continue working. This side is staying the same for right now, x minus 3 over 2 squared. And it will be equal to, again, we now have our common denominator that we want, 4. So we can go ahead and add the two numerators. We have 6 plus 9, which is 15, all over 4. Now that we have it set up so that we have something squared equals a number, we can go ahead and use that square root principle or square root property that tells us we can solve this just by taking the square root of both sides. When we do, we need to throw in a little extra something, though. So we have the square root of both sides. Here, the square root and the square will simplify out for us, and we're just left with x minus 3 over 2. This is great because it means it's very simple for us to finally solve for x, which is the purpose of the whole problem. On this side, we're not just going to have the square root of 4 over 2. We're going to have plus or minus the square root of 4 over 2, and that's that thing that the square root principle tells us, the square root property tells us, that when we take the square root of both sides, we need to make sure that we include this plus or minus in our final answer, because it is not one answer we get, but two. We need them both. Now, thanks to the property of radicals, we can simplify this fraction by realizing that it is the square root of 15 over the square root of 4. And we do this because we can take the square root of 4 and get rid of a little bit of it. Now, to solve, all I need to do is add my 3 over 2 to both sides. This gives me x equal to 3 over 2 plus or minus the square root of 15 and over the square root of 4, which is 2. And as I said, as fractions appear, they really do everything they can to be as user-friendly and helpful as possible. You notice that we have fractions here in our final answer. They're already set up with a common denominator for us, which means we can put this together as a single answer where we get 3 plus or minus the square root of 15, that entire amount, over 2. And that's our final answer. It's actually two answers. We have 3 plus the square root of 15 over 2, and 3 minus the square root of 15 over 2.